Good morning, class 7. Today we will start with chapter 8 of your civics book, A Shirt in the Market. Now you will wonder, the name is little weird, you can say, but here we will understand the market, how does the market economy works. Now, you can say this is more of economical, like you will be studying about related things related to economy. So it will be more of your economic background than your civics background, right? Okay, this chapter tells us the story of a shirt. It begins with the production of cotton and ends with the sale of the shirt. We shall see that a chain of market links the producer of the cotton to the buyer of the shirt in the supermarket. Buying and selling takes place at every step in the chain. Does everyone benefit equally from this, or do some people benefit more than others? We shall find out. So in this chapter we are going to study how the people begin with the manufacturing of a shirt, and once all those people who are involved in all in the production of the shirt, that is a producer, then the buyer, and then we will be talking about who all are benefiting. Are they benefiting equally, or somebody is benefiting more in comparison to the other person? So all that we are going to study in this chapter. A cotton farmer in Kurnool. Swapna, a small farmer in Kurnool, that is in Andhra Pradesh, grows cotton on her small piece of land. The balls of the cotton plant are ripe and some have already burst. So Swapna is busy picking cotton. The balls which carry the cotton in them do not burst open all at once. So it takes several days to harvest the cotton. So you can understand that they do not burst open simultaneously. So it is not like this that one person can go one day and take away all the balls. No, they have to wait, because see, it is written that they do not burst open all at once, so it takes several days to harvest. Now that means lot of hard work is required in this. Once the cotton is collected, instead of selling it at Kurnool cotton market, Swapna and her husband take the harvest to the local trade. At the beginning of the cropping season, Swapna had borrowed ₹2,500 from the trader at a very high interest rate to buy seeds, fertilizers, pesticides for cultivation. At that time, the local trader made Swapna agree to another condition. He made her promise to sell all her cotton to him. So there we are talking about a case history of Swapna. So she has taken 2,500 rupees as a loan from a trader, and the condition was that she will give her cotton to him. He has taken lot of interest, a very high interest on that amount. Although she has invested that amount in the seed, by purchasing of the seeds, she has purchased fertilizers, pesticides, all these things are required for the sake of cultivation. So cultivation of cotton requires high levels of input such as fertilizers and pesticides, and the farmers have to incur heavy expenses on account of these. Most often the small farmers need to borrow money to meet these expenses. So for the sake of cultivation, a lot of amount has to be invested in it, for purchasing fertilizers, pesticides. The farmers, they have incurred they spend a lot of amount on all these things, and many times it happens that the small farmers, they need money, so they borrow money from the market at very high interest. At the trader's yard, two of his men weigh the bags of cotton at a price of ₹1,500 per quintal. The cotton fetches ₹6,000. The trader deducts ₹3,000 for repayment of loan and interest and pays Swapna ₹3,000. Swapna, 3,000 only? Cotton is selling cheap. There is a lot of cotton in the market. Swapna, I have toiled so hard for 4 months to grow this cotton. You can see how fine and clean the cotton is this time. I had hoped to get a much better price. So when the person who measured the cotton, he said, they agreed to give 1,500 for per quintal, that is 100 kgs. And it was she got total amount as 6,000. The trader took the loan which he had given. So 2,500 he had given and 500 he took as the interest. So he took 3,000 and gave 3,000 to Swapna. But she was shocked. And she said that this time the cotton is also a very good quality and she had worked very hard on this. So it was very less. But the trader said to her that cotton is very cheap and it is available everywhere. But Swapna is a little disappointed and she says that I was expecting much better price this time as she had worked very hard. Right? You can see the chart here. First is trader sells the cotton to the Kurnool cotton market. Then second is ginning mill buys the cotton. Third, ginning mill removes the seeds and presses the cotton into bales. Spinning mill buys the bales. Then spinning mill spins the cotton into yarn. Spinning mill sells the yarn to yarn dealers. So what happens is the trader, they sell the cotton to the Kurnool cotton mill, that is the cotton mill market, and where there the ginning mill, which the purpose where they gin it, they buy the cotton and they separate the seed and press the cotton into bales. Then the spinning mill, first ginning mill takes up, then spinning mill takes it. Spinning mill takes the bales. Then spinning mill bales these, spin the cotton into yarn. Ginning mill, what they do is they separate the cotton from the seed and they press into bales. Bales are taken by the spinning mill and spinning mill, they spin the bales into yarn. And then spinning mill sells the yarn to yarn dealer. So now the trader, Amma, I am giving you a good price. Other traders are not even paying this much. You can check at Kurnool market if you do not believe me. So the trader tells her, he tries to convince her that I am giving you a very good amount. If you go to other trader, they will not give you even this much. And if you can don't believe me, he asked her to go and check at the Kurnool market. Swapna, don't be angry. How can I doubt you? I had only hoped that we would earn enough for the cotton crop to last us a few months. Though Swapna knows that cotton will sell for at least 1,800 per quintal, she doesn't argue further. The trader is a powerful man in the village and the farmers have to depend on him for loans, not only for cultivation, but also to meet other exigencies, such as illness, children's school fee. Also, there are times in the year when there is no work and no income for the farmers, so borrowing money is the only means of survival. Okay, so when the trader tries to convince her, Swapna says that now don't get angry. I am not doubting you. How can I doubt you? She said that she just had a hope that this time she will earn better and so that they could last long. That means the earning will save her family for quite a little more time. And she knew that the cotton which he is going to sell, he will sell it for at least 1,800 per quintal. But then she didn't argue with him because the trader was a powerful man in the village and farmers depended on him for the purpose of the loan. They could take loan for the sake of cultivation, sometimes for other emergencies like maybe for some illness, to pay the fee of their child or children. And at times when they had no work to do, then also they took money, borrowed money from the trader just for the sake of survival. Swapna's earning from cotton cultivation is barely more than what she might have earned as a wage laborer. So it is just little bit more than a wage laborer. That means a person who is getting who works as a laborer for the whole day and he earns his living like that. So her earning is just little bit more than him. So that's all for today class. Take care of yourselves. Please do read the chapter. Be safe at home. Thank you.